I mean, it looks really nice, actually. The black and white is gorgeous.
I couldn't let Drew take the title like last season, so I dreamed big by creating the ultimate smart, eco-friendly home to lure potential homeowners into this trendy LA neighborhood.
New entrance.
Oh, wow. I like the detail. I like all the cladding on the walls. I like your color choices. I love the full height glass at the front.
This might be one of the most dramatic transformations we've ever done.
Starting in the living room, I set out to give this Oceanside property a modern cottage makeover. I ran into a few setbacks.
Oh, wow. This looks like a safety nightmare.
Which started me off a bit over budget, but I turned the space into the ultimate room for entertaining, and it should bring a high return at the closing table.
I like it. I actually think everything you did here is really great. I mean, not Drew winning the living room challenge great, but it's great. That kitchen, though. Whew.
To create my masterpiece open concept kitchen, I took down a few walls and installed an expensive giant support beam.
That is a serious piece of steel.
All right, amazing. Your island is bigger than mine, and I have a massive island.
I did go over budget again, but the additional costs were worth it for this dramatic, high-tech space that will be the envy of the neighborhood.
My island also has integrated technology with the induction under the stone.
I will say I like how you went all out when it came to eco-conscious decisions.
I think that means a lot to the LA buyer.
You did a good job, but king of kitchens! This is the main bedroom suite.
Yeah. This bathroom didn't even exist before, so this is an all-new, beautiful main suite bathroom.
Mine's bigger.
I knew I needed to invest in the main bedroom suite because after the kitchen, that's where buyers will fall in love. After turning two rooms into one, I amped up the elegance by installing a tray ceiling.
This is the piece de resistance.
And distinctive chandelier to add wow factor to the soaring space.
It's good. I honestly think you've created a little haven for the main bedroom suite, which is pretty nice. I love the doors off to the back and you can see the fire pit. I know my room was bigger, but it's not the size that matters. It's which brother built it.
Cute zone.
That is adorable. Oh, you pulled the cat's tail on the wall. That nice. I think your color choices are awesome in here.
I tried to stay on budget in the three additional bedrooms because it's about profit margin, and beating Drew can come down to a few hundred bucks.
This is a little bit smaller than the other tub, so it was $300 less.
Yes.
And we didn't have to move the plumbing, which was gonna cost us $300.
Yes.
So that's a $600 differential, so that could be what we beat Drew with.
I designed rooms that were modern and sophisticated, where buyers could envision themselves relaxing at the end of a long day.
Oh, this is so much nicer.
It is a legal bedroom.
But that's not enough, so I threw in some mega eye candy, like the incredible smart TV in the den.
4K big screen TV rolls straight up.
That is crazy!
Get ready for this. No longer a dingy garage.
Wow, fancy, fancy.
Check this out. When you want it to be a bedroom.
Oh, nice. Okay, kudos to you, that is very cool.
Packing in all this technology into a tiny space, I think just makes it not just a functional space, but a cool space too.
I think the technology is why you won.
While transforming the garage into a bright and beachy ADU, I saved an incredible amount of money with smart decisions.
The collapsible doors are $16,000 and it will take a long time just to get here. So if we switch it to four sliders, you know, we can save $8,000.
Okay, let's do it.
Thanks, Gus. I also like all the black trim on the windows and everything too. Your kitchen is actually a little bigger than mine.
It also has a lot of stuff packed in that you wouldn't even notice. There's induction under the stone here, so you have everything that you need.
Where's your laundry?
What?
My idea has laundry. Where's your laundry?
I either had to choose laundry or storage, so I have a closet over here. There's also a full bath and everything, but no separate laundry.
This is nice. I think it's great. And you even have a little something for the locals.
Local flair.
Yeah, I'm just gonna go hit some waves.
If you ding anything.
Yeah, okay, perfect.
Get back here.
Inside and outside the home, I wanted to get buyers inspired about the life they can have here.
This is the most stylish outdoor kitchen I think I've ever seen.
Buy me! Buy me!
Big dollar!
Because selling a home is really selling a lifestyle.
Okay, I'll give it to Jonathan. He has completely transformed this house, and now I'm a bit nervous too.
Wow.
Oh, this is perfect.
Some kid is going to love this room.
I'm sure that the agents at my house won't have a hard time finding buyers. I'm just hoping that they have deeper pockets than Jonathan's buyers.
I love this barbecue and the stone. They even put the stone on here. Look at the little golf area.
Yes, the putting green.
This is so cute.
I am impressed. Drew took some big risks and made some bold design choices. So far, it's paid off because he did win 3 of the 5 challenges. Now it's up to the agents and buyers, and all we can do is wait for offers to come in and see who wins. So, let's talk facts. How many offers did you get? I assume you've got an offer.
Before I even put the house on the market, I already had real estate agents calling me. I had neighbors calling me for people that are family and friends to move in. I ended up with 14 offers.
You made that up.
I totally made that up. I had 2 offers.
Okay. I had multiple offers in the first day. Multiple.
Like multiple could be 2 or more.
Exactly the same as you. I had 2 offers.
I was nervous, and then I saw my second offer, and I was like, this is the one. This is a dream offer, so you should be nervous.
I'm not really that nervous.
What time it is?
To go for an 80s jog?
No. I have done all my calculations, and I know who the winner is. I love this part of every year. Yeah. Putting you guys in the blindfolds, taking you for a little drive.
At least tell us, was it close?
Well, I can tell you, there is a winner.
You tell us where we're going first, ocean or hillside, and let's go.
We are going to the ocean,
okay,
or the hillside.
Why do we have to put these on in the house? Why don't we just put them on in the garage?
Yeah, that makes more sense. Yeah, I should wait till we're up front.
Whack, right into a wall. If I can hear the ocean, then I know we're headed to my house and I won.
You can't hear anything.
Okay, guys. Are you ready?
Are we here?
We're here.
We are here.
Okay.
All right.
Hey, you guys ready?
Yeah. I was ready like an hour ago.
Stop here.
The winner of Brother versus Brother, No Rules, by $115,000 is... Remove your blinds.
I knew it! I knew it! I knew it! I knew it! I feel redeemed!
By $115,000?
Oh my God.
So close!
Hey. Oh. This is worth celebrating. Absolutely.
Good job, you guys.
Get in here, guys.
Good job,
this
guys.
This is amazing.
Well done. Thank you, guys.
Oh my gosh.
Congratulations.
Good job.
This win is extra sweet. I'll admit I was sweating at those first 3 challenges when Drew was on a winning streak.
Why?
But who's laughing now? This house cost me $1.25 million, and even though I spent $515,000 on the renovation, I sold it for $2,040,000, leaving me a winning profit of $275,000. No rules definitely worked out in my favor.
I had all those wins. I thought I was doing so good.
I knew he was spending. You won because you were spending.
I overspent. I did overspend. Go!
Oh my gosh.
It was the addition for the main bedroom suite.
Yeah.
Too much money. I won 3 of 5 challenges and managed to finally beat Jonathan in the kitchen. I sold my house for $1.71 million for a profit of $160,000, which is great considering how over budget I went. I guess I might have just overestimated the neighborhood, but I'm proud of what Chris, Breeze, and Team Drew accomplished, and for me, it was all while being a new dad.